welcome back to Radical Physics. Let's start with an apparently simple question. How fast are you moving right now? When I try to answer the question for myself, and don't just give the first obvious answer of zero, because, hey, I'm at rest, I focus on the spinning Earth. I'm standing on a huge ball that rotates once a day. If Earth is 24,000 miles in circumference, and if it takes 24 hours to rotate once, then a point on the equator must be moving, 24,000 miles in 24 hours, that's 1,000 miles per hour. That's impressive. San Francisco, at a latitude of 38 degrees, is moving at very nearly 800 miles per hour. That's faster than the speed of sound. I'm moving faster than Mach 1. I'm hypersonic. But it certainly doesn't feel as though I'm moving that fast. It doesn't feel as though I'm moving at all. Clearly, my intuitive understanding of speed is flawed. My understanding of motion itself needs to be deeper. A bit of depth is added as soon as I realize that speed is relative. My speed may be 800 miles per hour relative to the center of Earth, but it is zero relative to this globe and to that painted planet there and these ersatz stars. If you have any doubts about this subtle point of relativity, man, do I have the video for you. It's part of an ancient movie, ancient but truly wonderful. It's part one, just 8 minutes long, of perhaps the coolest physics movie ever made, called Frames of Reference. Check it out with this annotation link and then come on back. Let's define speed, though not very carefully at first. We'll come back in another episode and define speed carefully. For now, let's just use what you probably already know. Speed equals distance divided by time. In symbols, V equals D over T. Around the world, people use the symbol V for speed because of speed similarity to velocity, V vector. We'll make the important distinction between speed and velocity in a later episode, but V will always stand for speed. For now, speed equals D divided by T. We'll take the mathematics of division for granted. But should we take distance and time for granted? To embrace the spirit of radical physics, we should ask, what is distance and what is time? The truth is, though, that no one really knows. No one understands deeper features of reality upon which distance and time are based. Some things in introductory physics are taken for granted, and these are two of them. In radical physics, we'll do our best to keep the number of things taken for granted as small as possible. So far, that number is two, distance and time. We may not be able to understand distance and time, but we sure know how to measure them, and that's important. We're learning about science, after all, and measurement is crucial to science. The international unit of measurement for distance is the meter. Here's a meter-long stick. It's a little longer than an American yard. This distance is 1 meter. We've just got to get used to it. The international unit of measurement for time is the second. Most everyone knows how long a time that is. The duration of a human heartbeat is roughly 1 second. As long as you are in good health, and don't get so animated that your heart races, your pulse can help you to measure time in seconds. Better than your pulse would be a stopwatch, and many of us have stopwatches built into our telephones. So again, speed is distance divided by time. V equals D over T. Since we measure distance in meters and time in seconds, the equation tells us that the units of speed must be meters divided by seconds, meters per second. We treat the units just as if they were numbers and plug them into the equation. If you walk a distance of 1 meter in a time of 1 second, your speed is 1 meter per second. In U.S. units, that's a little more than 2 miles per hour. There's a good thing to remember. 1 meter per second equals about 2 miles per hour. That's easy walking speed. Meters per second are handy units for describing everyday speeds, and especially for doing physics. We need to get used to the meter per second. Let's do a memorable example right now. The world's fastest human is a title that is not well defined. Often, it refers to the sprinter who wins the 100-meter dash at the Olympic Games. So, the world's fastest human gets to hold the title for at least 4 years. At the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing, Usain Bolt ran a remarkable race. Nobody was close to him. Bolt's official time for the 100-meter dash was 9.69 seconds. He will hate us for doing this, but let's round 9.69 up to 10. Anybody that can run the 100-meter dash in 10 seconds is a world-class sprinter. After all, we just wanted to get an idea of how fast people can possibly run, so 10 seconds will be just fine. For the record, Bolt's personal best as of early 2012 was 9.58 seconds. But nobody thinks he'll get below 9.5. This means that 10 seconds will be a better estimate than 9 seconds for quite a few years to come. Speed equals distance divided by time. That's d over t, and in this case, that's 100 meters divided by 10 seconds. 10 meters per second, which is between 22 and 23 miles per hour. The so-called conversion factor from meters per second to miles per hour is a little bit bigger than 2. When you want to turn speed in miles per hour into speed in meters per second, and we'll want to do this often, just divide by 2. So 100 miles per hour is about 50 meters per second. Better yet, try to get used to the meter per second all by itself. 1 meter per second is walking speed. 10 meters per second is sprinting, fast. 100 meters per second is auto racing speed. 1,000 meters per second, 1 kilometer per second, that's jet fighter speed, Mach 3. And 10,000 meters per second, 10 kilometers per second, that's orbiting. The fastest human craft ever built are the two Voyager space probes. Relative to Earth, they are now moving at 17,000 meters per second, 17 kilometers per second. Note that we say that an object has speed. Speed can be had. That's significant. Some physics entities cannot be had. We'll encounter one of these in the very next radical physics episode, RP3. And we need to remember and understand that speed, again, is relative. Speed only has meaning with respect to a specified reference frame. To help drive this home, let's end this video with a 2-minute clip on basic relativity, the kind of relativity that Galileo grappled with. This video is unlike anything else in the Radical Physics series. It was produced by YouTube phenom Jack Conti. Even though you'll see my face again, Jack Conti's creativity is what's really at work.